So I got the cucumber. I'm gonna cut it. Get it in half. I'm not even gonna skin it. There we go. The French have had a special relationship. The cucumber. Next, I got the imitation crab, which is actually pollock fish. Okay. That was the imitation crab. Next, we got the avocado. This was one of the last pieces made by the Alewa firm. Just gonna cut it like this. It advertises the services of 8 qualified chiropodists, claim operations are painless, and offering a solution for sweating and inflamed feet. I'm gonna cut it like this.
Novel tricks such as turning pages and window tapping to attract attention could be incorporated.
So now we got the rice seasonings. We got the norikomi hurikake. We got sesame seed, black sesame seed. And we got another rice seasoning. Shisu huimi hurikake. And of course, we've got the ginger also. Here's the wasabi. Over a period of many months, using a mixture of lime, powdered wasabi, and lemon. And here's the rice. This demanding, time-consuming occupation is rarely profitable. Economists tend to lead double lives, following the most profitable proceeds to overpay, and even raise tellers and garden shapes after hours. We got the sushi bamboo roll thingy, and finally we got the nori sushi. And for this one, I'm just going to do half a sheet. So you notice on this sheet, on all nori sheets, there's a rough side and there's a smooth side. So basically the smooth side is gonna be on the bottom. The smooth side is gonna be at the bottom and the rough side is gonna be at the top. Next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna wet my hands a bit. And also make sure your hands are clean, of course. Take like a good handful. And you don't wanna press it too hard, just spread the rice evenly. Some more rice here. The contemporary collection is constantly growing and changing. This is another far more serious. You still want to make the rice fluffy, also. Robots and machines have found their place in industry and home.
These functional machines bear little resemblance to their automaton ancestors. Unlike the clockwork interior of past centuries automata, where cause and effect can be visibly traced, the electronic entrails of today's robots belie the movements they command.
All right.
This IBM robot.
There you go. So I'm going to start laying out the insides of the sushi. Actually, no. Wait. I'm going to make a reverse. I'm going to do this.
And so the serious rub shoulders with a frizz.
Then I'm going to
listen. That.
Put some of this in here. And then I'm going to.
The saucy sailor gets his commands.
Set.
Big Bird Chaos has a dog called Order. It would be a tall order to order, Big Bird to order.
Just put that up here.
One of the last characters you will encounter as you leave the museum is the Laughing Man. Commissioned by a pharmaceutical firm to advertise a cure for kidney problems, is he trying to tell us that it's only his laughter that's infectious now? The Museum of Automata is above all a tribute to man's ingenuity and
sensibility. So now the next thing I'm going to do.
Out of the visions of our ancestors have appeared the robots of today. And along that pathway.
There you go. You want to make the insides as evenly as possible. So. Roll away. And you open it up. So this is how you cut it. You whip the knife. Make sure the knife is sharp. This is sort of sharp. Reverse it, then put all the good stuff here.
Leonardo da Vinci stated, "Mechanical engineering is the paradise of mathematical science, since the former allows one to reap the fruit of the latter." Exercising his art in the age of enlightenment, Pierre Jacquet,
right.
A master watchmaker and creative craftsman, astonished and beguiled the courts of Europe and Asia. Thanks to his talent, knowledge, and capacity, he devised and built extremely sophisticated clocks and watches, enhanced by music and animated figurines called automatons. Assisted by his son, Henri, the artist resumed a good professional engineer, as well as Michaud, who became their associate. Jacques Wolf produced automatons carrying a great picture, the triumph of the human mind over the forces of matter. Pioneers in algorithm calculation, their creation gave shape to a dream. That man climbed higher over the planets, diving into the ocean depths, or bursting into space.
There you go. Actually, I think I do this last one.
In terms of excitement, and its capacity to create natural movements and sounds was widely appreciated among the public of connoisseurs.
Just roll it. There you go. Then I will cut it.
Fit a songbird in its own box, the oscillations of the inertia block gradually wind the spring thanks to a click system. On the advice of the governor of Michelin, Lord Keith, Pierre Jacquet-Paul decided to travel to Spain to present his clocks. On April 4th, 1758, Jacquet-Paul left La Chaux-de-Fonds for Madrid, a journey that would take 49 days. This risky and sometimes dangerous adventure culminated in a result worthy of the undertaking. After 3 months spent awaiting an audience, he met King Ferdinand VI and presented his works, of a type similar to this rare amphora-shaped clock with an impassive striking mechanism. Jacquet-Paul was indeed the first to introduce the shaped moon. A short while later, the king rewarded Jacquet-Paul with 2,000 gold pistoles, sum which, upon his return to the Michelin Mountains, gave him the means to pursue his art to even higher peaks of achievement. From 1773 onwards, more innovative and transcendent than ever, the Jacquet-Paul presented increasingly sophisticated automatons.